Good morning, Sprayberry. I'm Shannon.
And I'm Cassandra.
We hope you're sporting your Sprayberry apparel for Spirit Day. Welcome back to The Swarm. Today is October 5th, 2018. At this time, please stand for the pledge, followed by a moment of quiet reflection.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
For today's quote of the day, we have, "Without struggle, there can be no progress." Frederick Douglass.
Today's SAT word of the day is query, meaning question, doubt, and mind. An example of that word in a sentence is, the magazine editor compiled a list of queries for a fact checker to address.
On this day in history, in 1947, President Harry Truman makes the first ever televised presidential address from the White House, asking Americans to cut back on their use of grain in order to help starving Europeans.
Homecoming tickets are on sale through all lunches for $15. Tickets can also be purchased through My Payments Plus at any time until Friday at 3:30. The dance will be held in the Commons this Saturday from 7 to 10 p.m. Homecoming t-shirts are on sale in the school store for $10, so be sure to grab one. Now for a short commercial break.
Whatever happened to predictability? The milkman, the paperboy, evening TV. You miss your old familiar friends, but waiting just around the bend. Everywhere you look, everywhere there's you go.
Breast Cancer Awareness Month is a yearly campaign that intends to educate people about the importance of early screening, tests, and more. This campaign runs through the month of October every year. In 1993, Evelyn Lauder founded the Breast Cancer Research Foundation and established the pink ribbon as its symbol, though this was not the first time the ribbon was used to symbolize breast cancer. Although rare, males are also susceptible to breast cancer. This annual international health campaign organized by major breast cancer charities every October to increase awareness of the disease and to raise funds for research into its cause, prevention, diagnosis, treatment, and a cure.
Attitudes Hair Salon, as well as Ms. Rao from Cosmetology, are offering a homecoming special at the hair salon. Girls' blowouts are $40, formal hairstyles are $35, long hair is $45, boys' haircuts are just $10. Attitudes Hair Salon is located across the street behind Chick-fil-A next to Zama's Mexican restaurant. Come out and get your hair done for homecoming. Remember, all hair must be shampooed already.
Let's see what Chelsea has for us.
What's up, Sprayberry? Chelsea here back with the daily weather. Throughout this weekend, it will be mostly sunny with temperatures ranging from low 90s to high 60s. It's going to feel pretty humid, so make sure to dress well, especially if you're planning on coming to the homecoming parade and game tonight. That's all I got for you today. Now back to Shannon and Cassandra.
If you want to sign up for your club to participate in Trunk or Treat this year, please scan the QR code on your screen. Trunk or Treat will be held October 25th, so make sure to bring your families. Let's see how our classes are competing this week.
What's up, Sprayberry? I'm your host, Sean, and for today's Battle of the Class episode, we're going to be doing Tug of War. Now, let's meet our contestants.
My name is Jay, and I represent the freshman class.
Hi, I'm Zoe. I represent the sophomore class.
Hi, my name is Skylar, and I represent the junior class.
Hi, my name is Paulina, and I represent the senior class.
And now, without further introduction, let's get into the battle.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
And the winner of the first round is?
Sophomore class.
All right, so your winner for the second round is?
Junior class.
And the winner of the final round is?
Zoe Grant for sophomore class.
All right, winner, so you got anything to say?
Shout out to my basketball team. Love y'all. That's it.
All right, Sprayberry, that's all we got for you today on Battle of Classes. See you next time.
Until October 15th, we will be honoring generations of Hispanic Americans who have positively influenced and enriched our nation and society. Check out this video.
Cesar Chavez was born March 31st, 1927 and died April 23rd, 1993. He was an American labor leader and civil rights activist who co-founded the National Farm Workers Association and the United Farm Workers Union. Originally a Mexican farm worker, he became the best-known Latino American rights activist and was strongly promoted by the American labor movement. To this day, he remains a major historical icon for the Latino community and has had many public sites named after him.
Now for Sprayberry Sports.
What's good, Sprayberry? It's your boy DJ Patrick back at it again with Sprayberry Sports. Stay tuned to see what we have for you today. Today, our Yellow Jackets will play Osmo High School here at home for a region game. Let's witness our Jackets get their second conference win of the season. Tomorrow, cross country will be participating in the A6 Invitational at Fox Halls Farms Sporting Club at 8 a.m. That's it for today, Sprayberry. Make sure you support our fellow Jackets. Now back to Cassandra and Shannon.
Teachers, please remember this semester this form records a day before it airs. And please send all announcements to sprayberrynews@gmail.com. Thank you everybody for watching and enjoying our show. We'll see you next week. And remember, Jackets, together we swarm.
Together we swarm.